Lagrangian Optimization Explained. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving into a fundamental tool in the Economist's toolkit, Lagrangian Optimization. If you've taken an intro microeconomics course, you may have heard the term tossed around. But what does it actually mean? This video is your crash course on how Lagrangian optimization helps us make the most of limited resources. Whether you're a student tackling problem sets or just a curious learner, this one's for you. At its core, Lagrangian optimization is a method for solving problems with constraints. Named after the 18th century mathematician Joseph-Louis Lagrange, this technique is widely used in economics, engineering, and even machine learning. So, why do economists care? Because economic agents, like consumers and firms, don't have unlimited resources, and therefore, they all face constraints. A consumer might want to maximize their utility, but they're limited by a budget. A firm might want to maximize revenue, but they're constrained by costs or production capacity. Lagrangian optimization lets us mathematically figure out the best possible choice for an agent, given their constraints. Let's use a classic microeconomic example. Imagine a consumer deciding how much tea and how many biscuits to buy. They want to maximize their utility, but they only have a certain amount of money to spend. This is where the budget constraint comes in. If P1 is the price of tea, and Q1 is the quantity of tea, and P2 and Q2 are the same for biscuits, our budget constraint looks like this. Q1 multiplied by P1 plus Q2 multiplied by P2 less than or equal to A, where A is the total amount of money the consumer has. Feel free to pause the video and double-check the equation. Now, here's the key assumption. Economics typically assumes that the budget is binding, meaning the consumer spends all their money. So, we write, Q1 multiplied by P1 plus Q2 multiplied by P2 equal to A. That makes sense, right? If you're trying to maximize your satisfaction, you wouldn't leave money unspent. Now, we can reframe this problem. Let's combine the objective function with the budget constraint and add a new Lagrange multiplier to create a Lagrangian function. We skipped the consumer's objective function before, but that's just their utility function, which is what they want to maximize. Take a look at our utility maximization video if you need a refresher. When we combine the objective function, the budget constraint, and the Lagrange multiplier, it looks like this. L, open parenthesis, Q1, Q2, lambda, close parenthesis, equals U, open parenthesis, Q1, Q2, close parenthesis, minus lambda, open parenthesis, Q1 multiplied by P1 plus Q2 multiplied by P2 minus A, close parenthesis. Here, U, parenthesis, Q1, Q2, close parenthesis, is a utility function. Lambda is the Lagrange multiplier. Lambda is being multiplied with the same exact budget constraint we had before, rearranged. The idea is to find the values of Q1 and Q2 that maximize utility while respecting the budget. We do this by taking partial derivatives of the Lagrangian with respect to each variable and setting them equal to zero. Partial L divided by partial Q1 equals partial U divided by partial Q1 minus lambda P1 equals zero. Partial L divided by partial Q2 equals partial U divided by partial Q2 minus lambda P2 equals zero. Partial L divided by partial lambda equals A minus Q1 P1 minus Q2 P2 equals zero. This last equation? That's just our budget constraint again. Reassuring, right? So, what's the deal with lambda, the Lagrange multiplier? Think of it as the rate at which utility increases when the budget increases by one unit. For example, $1. In other words, lambda tells you how valuable one extra dollar is to the consumer. Lambda answers the question, how much more utility can $1 buy this consumer? If lambda equals 5, then an extra dollar of budget would let the consumer increase their utility by 5. Pretty cool, right? In real-world economics, lambda can signal where policy changes or income transfers might have the biggest impact. Let's bring it to life with an example. Say we solve the system of equations and find that Q1 equals 5 cups of tea, Q2 equals 10 biscuits. This tells us that under the current prices and budget, the optimal consumption bundle is 5 teas and 10 biscuits. Plug those values back into the utility function, and voila, you've got the maximum utility. And don't worry, while this can look intimidating, in class, you'll typically use a simple Cobb-Douglas utility function like U, open parenthesis, Q1, Q2, close parenthesis, equals to Q1 to the power of 0.5 multiplied by Q2 to the power of 0.5. From here, solving the equations just becomes algebra. A question that often comes up is, if people are supposed to spend their entire budget, where do savings fit in? Great question. In this framework, savings can be treated like any other good. You purchase savings by spending money on it. So if you include savings as one of the goods, the optimization still holds. This is partly why you'll rarely talk about savings when you learn about Lagrangian optimization in class. This simplifies things for now. But remember, in macroeconomics, savings often gets more detailed treatment because it plays a larger role in long-term growth and interest rate dynamics. Now here's the best part. This technique doesn't stop with consumers. Lagrangian optimization is also used by firms to maximize revenue or profit, subject to constraints like costs, labor availability, or resource limitations. The process to set up and solve this type of problem is exactly the same. You just switch the utility function for a revenue function, and instead of prices constraining your budget, you'll usually have costs per unit produced instead. Even advanced models like Bertrand, Cournot, or Stackelberg competition use similar methods. The math grows more complex, but the core logic stays the same. Let's wrap it up. Lagrangian optimization helps us solve constraint optimization problems. It's especially useful in economics where agents face budget or cost constraints. The Lagrange multiplier, lambda, tells us how much the objective function improves with more resources. It's used by both consumers and firms, and it's a gateway to more advanced math used in microeconomics. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more deep dives into economics concepts. Got questions about this method? Be sure to check out the Lagrangian optimization article and practice problems on the Economics website. We've developed a detailed step-by-step process for you to follow. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep thinking like an economist.